Now, most of the slides which are going to come are actually a repetition of what we just talked. So I'm going to go through them fast. Range of motion, I said, in different directions, you have to test active as well as passive. What I showed. Now, this is what was the supraspinatus. This is the infraspinatus. This is again infraspinatus lift off. This is basically for stretching the teres minor and infraspinatus. Or sometimes when you have an anterior labral tear, this can get pinched with this kind of test. This is your subscapularis. Impingement in a different format, what I was showing. This is impingement again in a different format. These are all different ways of testing the strength which I showed you. Now, these are all things which are not done routinely, what I was telling you, you know, apprehension test. So much of abduction and all, they will dislocate if they are recurrent dislocators. This is too much of a positioning. This is another way of examining laxity. You can push the head of humerus anteroposteriorly if they are very lax, either by making them lie down or sitting by next to them. Like if they are sitting here, you sit next to them and hold the scapula, hold the head of humerus and take them front and back. Koi thin one pe dikha sakta hu. Aaja idhar ek minute. So hold the scapula and hold the head of humerus and tell the patient to relax. Dheela chod bilkul. Now see this. I can do this translation. This much translation is acceptable because the glenoid is flat and shallow. But dislocatable ones are almost where you can feel it's going up and coming back with a click. Okay, thanks. Sorry, you were asking something. Shoulder dislocations. Yes, I am going to come that also, because you guys have to learn the art of reducing a shoulder dislocation, because it's extremely painful, and if you are getting it immediately, then if you reduce it immediately, then that much less edema for the patient, because otherwise remaining outside will cause edema.